The next thing I want to do here is I want to click on Show More Options. And this gives us, hey, look, I can put my website in here, which obviously I want to do, especially if this is to the sales page of a product. Ticket seller information, this can be branding, right? And then the YouTube URL. Now, again, this is not going to instantly create a live hangout on air for you as soon as you start this event. You need to go into your hangout and start the live hangout on air about a half an hour before your event actually starts. Then you want to come into here and post the YouTube video watch page URL and post it in there. That's what puts the little video box in the event page like you saw in the previous example. Now that YouTube link will be the same exact link live and afterwards in the replay. So basically when you drop the link in here and then you broadcast live, you don't need to worry about any other links. The live link is the same as the replay link. So then after that, you've got that awesome video right there in the event page, and you've got all the people who are already used to coming to the page, watching the video live, making their comments live in the event page. You can be looking at the event page as you're doing the hangout, answering questions, responding to questions vocally in the hangout itself, while also, you know, writing your comment and response back. Again, makes it extremely, extremely engaging for these people. Live hangouts on air is not the only thing that this is used for, but for us internet marketers, we're all about it. This is just if it's a physical location, this is the information that you put in for transient parking. Finally, we come to, right? This is, so again, you can invite all of your circles, you can invite the public, you can invite extended circles, or you can do like we're going to be doing, is invite communities. If we keep circling down, these are all of my circles here. Scrolling down, here are all the different communities. You can tell because it has this little icon here. If we go to the community leader and say, I want to do an interview with you, I want to do it in 5 days, then what you'll do is you'll set up the event and you'll put the time in for 5 days later, or heck, even 2 weeks out. It doesn't matter, because the live YouTube link won't be created until half an hour before the event actually starts. But you can plan this out a year in advance if you want, and then share it with the community, and those are the only people who will be able to see it and be a part of it and interact with it. So once you've chosen who you want to invite this event to, of course you got to have your title in, then you can click invite. And once you do that, it'll invite all of the people, it'll create an event page just like the one you saw before, and then you can start adding more details to it. You can go back and edit it, you can add comments, you can start a conversation, which I highly recommend doing, and it just has this continual snowball effect before, during, and after the hangout actually happens. Some final notes before we go and move on into pages in the next module. I want to give you some tips to make this a little bit more engaging. If you can make a trailer or a preview video, which is like maybe a 2 minute quick snapshot interview, an actual hangout with the creator of the community, as a teaser, you can post that video in the event before the hangout actually starts and then swap it out with the live feed later. What this does is it starts the conversation, it gets people interested, it puts the hangout that they will be attending into context and gets them really excited. Of course, you're going to want to invite your circles, encourage the community leader to broadcast to their circles. If they have an email list, broadcast this link, the link to the event page, to everybody they possibly can, to get as many people on the live event, because when you do that, you just get so much more interaction. It's a great time, and a lot of people see you as a greater authority. Of course, this goes without saying, you want to make sure and invite the community leader to the event page as well, so that other people can see that they're going. And also, anytime somebody posts a comment or anything on the event page, those who say, yes, I'm going, will be notified. So if any changes happen that the community leader isn't aware of, they will be notified because they said that they would attend the live event. And you'd be surprised, but a lot of people don't do that, so you need to make sure and remind them. The last note here that I want to point out is that when it comes to a live event, you have to create the hangout, the live hangout on air, just before the event starts. Now, this can be frustrating because you want to be able to send people to a direct link that people can watch the video instantly. And that can be really frustrating if you don't have the link right away. So as a substitute, until you are able to get that live YouTube link when you create the live Hangout on Air, use this link, and it's posted in the associated PDF guide, but it's youtube.com/user/live. Now, you can send this link to anybody you want and say, at this time, you will click on this link and you will be taken directly to the current live broadcast of that YouTube channel. Okay? Now, if someone clicks on that link before a live event is happening, all it will do is take people to the YouTube channel. So, with that, even if they click on it and there's nothing for them to see, they still see your YouTube channel and they know, oh, okay, well, at 2 o'clock Mountain Standard Time, I need to click on this link and I'll go directly to it. But it's very, very highly encouraged that you do this in connection with creating an event, because you want to drive people to the event page to register, to interact, and also ultimately visit that same page to watch the live event and comment even further. So I know that was a lot, but thanks for sticking with me. This is a really, really, really good concept that you need to wrap your head around. Every single time someone says, hey, I did this hangout, I say, did you make an event? And most of the time they didn't, and they regret not doing it. So anytime you possibly can, create an event in Google+. It will do great things for you before, during, and after the event is over. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next module.